Welcome to the show, Excellence in All Things. I'm your host, Barbara Golar. Today, I am so excited to have in studio our Interfaith Council of Monrovia. But before I introduce these wonderful people to all of Monrovia, I know you've probably seen some of us out there, but before I introduce you to them, I want to read to you their mission statement, their statement and their mission statement. Oh, Interfaith Council of Monrovia, reflecting, and you know what I'm going to do, because I'm losing my voice and I want it to be very clear, I'm going to turn it over to one of our members so they can read. Neil, can you read for me, please? Oh, all right, sure. Thank you. I can feel it now.
The Interfaith Council of Monrovia statement. Reflecting on and appreciating racial, ethnic, and cultural diversity of the city of Monrovia, many people of faith in our community feel that it is the right time for us to gather together our religious communities for the purpose of bringing hope and understanding. We are committed to making Monrovia a place which reflects the best that this nation can be. Throughout the history of humanity, religion has played an important part in the international relations. In 1893, during the World's Fair, Columbian Exposition in Chicago, the world witnessed not only the birth of the Ferris wheel, but also the birth of interreligious dialogue. A formal meeting during that Chicago fair brought together interreligious figures from many traditions. The first Parliament of World Religions set the foundation for discourse and cooperation among different faiths that is so essential in helping to maintain open lines of communication and peace in the world today. The mission of the Interfaith Council of Monrovia is to bring together representatives of various faith communities and religious organizations, as well as interested individuals, for the purpose of dialogue, information sharing, celebration, and social transformation. We honor the rich variety of religious and spiritual traditions of our community, and we gather to create a mosaic that represents differences while celebrating all that unites us. We strive to be a forum for greater understanding, a vehicle for spiritual enrichment, a force for justice and peace, a voice for the vulnerable and the defenseless, and an advocate for the wise stewardship of the earth and its resources.
I'd like to introduce these wonderful people to all of you out there. So we'll start with to my left.
Hi, Esma Ali. I represent the Muslim faith. Now, we have several mosques in the area. One closest to us is in Monrovia on the corner of Buena Vista. And so any of you is welcome anytime to any of the mosques. We'd love to have you as a guest, an observer, or anything of the sort.
Okay, thank you.
And I'm Mike Antonesi. I'm one of the directors at Foothill Unity Center. We are a secular organization that's been a part of the Interfaith Council for many years. We like to say that we put the unity in community. So we actually serve as a unifying factor for those that are that we serve. And we serve those that live in our communities, about 11 communities in the San Gabriel Valley, who are living under the poverty level. So we have a multi-service food pantry that provides services of food and medical and social services to all those who are in need in the San Gabriel Valley. I'm very happy to be here, Barbara.
Thank you.
Thank you, Barbara, for inviting me to this TV show. My name is Ron Sanchez. I'm a deacon at Immaculate Conception Parish here in Monrovia, and I've been a deacon for about 10 years now. And our Catholic Church in Monrovia has been around since 1905, as a matter of fact, and we are very proud of that history. So once again, thank you very much for the invitation, Barbara.
You're welcome. Yeah.
My name's Jenny Nielsen, my friend. I'm a member of the First Church of Christ Scientist, Monrovia, and we also, besides having church services and a testimony meeting for healings that we've experienced through prayer on Wednesday nights, And the reading room is all over the world as well, where people can come in and study the Bible, study the writings of Mary Baker Eddy, the founder and discoverer of the power of prayer to heal,
yes,
which is what we're all doing,
mm-hmm,
and very glad to be here.
Now, you're still located on
Alta Vista and Foothill, yeah, right, yes.
Yes, hi, I'm the Reverend Neil Tadkin. I'm the rector at St. Luke's Episcopal Church here in Monrovia, which is the corner of Foothill and California Avenue. I've been here in leadership at that parish for about 5.5 years, and joined the Interfaith Council shortly after arriving, and I've always found it to be a great opportunity to just, you know, build relationships across, you know, the faith spectrum, and enrich my own spiritual and cultural life.
Yes, yes. Thank you all. All of a sudden, I'm feeling really emotional here, because as you all know, here, sitting here, and that, you know, my sister Joni was one of the ones that had started, you know, reaching out and getting this going and moving forward. So, and, you know, this month, on the 18th, marks 2 years since her passing. So, I mean, this is, it is emotional, but it's a happiness,
mm-hmm,
you know. So with all of that, I'd like for you all to also kind of share why you even got started, you know, wanting to join the Interfaith Council of Monrovia. So who wants to start?
Well, Esme was one of the founders with Joni.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, my interest for joining the Interfaith Council, a lot of people have this attitude, it's my way or the highway. I'm the only one who's got the passport to heaven and you're all going downhill. That's the attitude that a lot of people have, and I don't think that's what God has intended. There's one verse in the Quran that, you know, I've created you into different nations and tribes. If I wanted you all to be Muslim, I could have done it with a snap of the finger, and God has the power. But he purposely created everyone into different nations and tribes so that we can get to know each other and not, you know, put up the boxing gloves.
Yes, yes, yes.
And
yes,
so that's why I joined, so that we could work together and to support the community, like in what Foothill does in their endeavors and all that, and make the community better, getting to know each other. That's my goal.
Yes.
I was pretty much a minority in being a, you know, what you might call a typical WASP. I grew up on Long Island. Almost all of my closest friends in school were Jewish. So I went to more bar mitzvahs than I went to confirmations, by a long shot. And then I traveled quite a bit because my dad was an airline pilot. So we had the opportunity to really see a lot of the world,
right,
in different
uh-huh.
cultures and different settings. And it always fascinated me. I wasn't raised with any sort of exclusivist view
mm-hmm.
of salvation or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I was in high school, I was an exchange student to Indonesia, and I lived with a Muslim family. And got to know the people there, and they were some of the most amazingly generous and just welcoming. It was a real eye-opening
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Experience, and I loved it there, and I loved the people, and you know, so from an early age, I it just made sense to me that God was, you know, working in us in many different ways,
right,
and creating
yeah. mm-hmm.
quite a lovely you know, patchwork of paths,
mm-hmm.
And so interfaith work just naturally came out of that when I sort of rediscovered the core of my own faith
mm-hmm.
and how I wanted to express that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for us, Foothill Unity Center has been in part of this community for 39 years. We actually started as a small closet in Immaculate Conception Parish. And when one person, Josephine, who had a passion for helping people, mm-hmm. decided to start giving away food out of that little closet. Well, the other churches and religious organizations in the neighborhood found out about it and said, hey, I want to do that too. So they unified it and they became Foothill Unity Center. So they've been a part of this interfaith activity from the very foundation of what we do. Josephine Anderson, there it is. So Betty McWilliams, our current executive director, is very adamant and excited about, yes. being a part of our, right. this organization, so that we can remain connected to all faiths of in the community, not focusing on any one, but being that unifying factor of all faiths.
Right. Yeah. Yes.
Well, it's all of our faiths call us to live that out in the world,
right.
and to be of service. Mm-hmm. And it becomes a great way for all of us to exercise our callings, mm-hmm. in a communal setting, mm-hmm. Rather than duplicate everything, have one food pantry at a mosque and one food pantry at a, mm-hmm. temple, and one food,
yes.
pantry at the church, whatever.
Right. Yep. I think that shows that together we are stronger, mm. because resources,
Absolutely.
Combining resources together in the name of just, not in particular name of any particular religion, but in the name of humanity, mm. in the name of community, and yeah. I think that's what Foothill represents.
Yeah, and that plays through, because there are many houses of worship of all varieties that have been strong supporters of the organization, mm-hmm. for over 30 years.
Right.
So,
right.
And we couldn't do it without them.
Yeah.
Well, I really believe in interfaith dialogue that goes along with our getting to know one another and having had the opportunity to read, mm-hmm. about Muhammad, to read the Quran, to read Baha'i writings, mm-hmm. take classes, even as a student of Christian Science, following Jesus' teachings, his healings, his message of peace for all. It's this universal truth. And the founder of Christian Science, Mary Baker Eddy, writes in Science and Health, truth is the center of all religion. So looking at that center, that core, that consciousness that we all embody, mm-hmm. brings us together, not only really to see what we have in common, but also to understand why we may differ in certain, very certain ways, but leading us to prayer, leading us to ethics, morality, civility, love, kindness,
yes,
everything.
Absolutely,
that
absolutely.
Makes it all good.
Absolutely.
It also gives us an opportunity to try to understand the other religions, mm-hmm. and to let us know that we are really in the same boat, and that each in our own ways we want to attain a truth and an understanding. And being with the Interfaith Council, it shows us that we have a common goal,
mm-hmm.
a common goal. And if we can have that together, then we will have true faith.
Right. Go ahead.
One thing that this group has really motivated me to do is to study the other scriptures. I read the book by Mary Baker Eddy, given to my friend here, cover to cover. The point is to empathize, put yourself in that position instead of labeling that person as the other. Automatically, I'm a Muslim, that's the other, and that's the dangerous path to go down on. And so studying the Bible thoroughly and studying the New Testament, Old Testament, Hindu, Buddhist scriptures, I think has helped me to understand others who are different and carry on dialogues, which I may or may not agree with, but at least step into that out of the comfort zone. And I think a lot of people are hesitate to do that.
Yeah, and the also, the other thing, I think it's also important for people to see all of us together, and us working together, mm-hmm. and because on your at work, you know, that's not talked about, what your faith is. And so, but when they see it outwardly, that us out in the community, us doing things together, then, you know, it then it's going to start looking different. And they're wanting to figure out, okay, I want to know more about how this works. It's not that, excuse me, it's not that someone is trying to convert, or it has nothing to do with any of that. Like Esma said earlier, it's about being part of humanity. You know, we have to look at each other as human beings, not as whatever your faith tradition is at all. And until all of us start coming together, oh my goodness, what would this world would be looking like?
A lot of other churches and other faith members to join our group here, there was a little bit of hesitancy that, you know, what's the use of trying to get to know a Hindu or Muslim or a Baha'i unless I'm there to proselytize and change them and bring them my way? There is no use of joining such a group, is what I've noticed, the attitude out there. And that, I think, is completely wrong, that we have to break that. And then instead of proselytizing, just work together. We have so much in common. I've discovered as far as treating how you treat other people, feeding the hungry, improving our environment, all of those things that are God-given messages to us that we're all trying to follow together.
Right, exactly, mm-hmm. Exactly. One other thing, there's two events that this council puts together. One is our the National Day of Prayer and our Thanksgiving celebration. And that's a time that we encourage our community, as well as our own faith tradition, to come out to see us all work together. The thing that I'm really excited about, guys, this year is actually that we're going to actually be in the Monrovia Days Parade that's coming up in May. So you'll see us in full force out in the community.
National Day of Prayer, we'll be meeting, you know, with Arcadia at Temple Beth David.
Right, which is also really nice that there's times that we join in with Arcadia Interfaith Council. I know their name is another
Alliance.
And so this year, once again, we will be meeting up with them at
May 2nd,
7 o'clock
at Temple Beth David in Temple City.
Yes, yeah. The other thing is that we are actually looking for new members to come to join us that you're interested in what we just talked about today on. You know, like-minded, wanting, you know, people to work together. You don't have to be a faith tradition, you know, like we have Foothill Unity Center. Any individual or group, my voice is going again, guys, to join us.
Come join us, attend our events, get to know us, and work with us in solving this so many difficulties out there. There's nothing that cannot be resolved if we need to sit down and dialogue together.
Yes, yes.
This is an invitation to encounter, to be in community.
I like that.
And this is a wonderful chance to come together, as mm-hmm. Esma has mentioned.
Yeah.
And there are occasionally, aside from the actual events that the Interfaith Council sponsors, we all share with each other various events in our traditions,
right.
And invite each other to those sorts of mm-hmm. Opportunities as well, which has been incredible. I mean, to be able to break the fast at the,
yeah.
at the end of Ramadan, or mm-hmm. you know, to go to the care banquet. I mean, the invitations are plenty, and we keep each other abreast of all kinds of events coming up, whether they're musical or whether they're community activism opportunities, etc. So I find it quite a blessing in my own life.
Yeah, at a time in our country, in our world, where there's so much disunity, we seek unity. And the opportunity to speak to each other and to dialogue to one another and to help one another, to be each other's helping hands. Mm-hmm. So this organization is a valuable asset to this community and probably the best kept secret in our community. So hopefully, as we come to you on the TV today with the invitation, please take us up on it to become involved and make a difference in your community.
Yes. I'm just going to emphasize again that if someone does not have a so-called faith tradition, or a church, or a temple, or a mosque, or whatever, you're just so very welcome.
Absolutely.
Very welcome to come. We all have heart and soul, and we're all being guided.
Yes, yes. The other thing I also want to say is that our news is bombarded with a lot of negative stuff, and unfortunately, there is also a lot of people that's out there that is doing good and also want to bring each of us together. Unfortunately, that's not what makes the news.
In fact, I get this question all the time. After 9/11, where were the Muslim voices condemning this or that? We were there, guys. But we don't make the news. It's boring news to watch someone as a peacemaker. That doesn't make the news. But we are out here, and not only are we out here, we are here with together when we're fighting the nonsense and the craziness that's going on in the society. And so I would like to invite you to join us and come on board.
Yes. Well, we're almost out of time. I know we've been saying a lot of little last words and stuff, but if there's something right now that is burning and pressing in your heart that you want to share with our viewers out there, anybody. Everybody.
I'm going to say something about what Neil read about the world religion and how it started so many, many decades, if not over a century ago.
1893?
Yes, yes. If anybody wants to look at that website for the World's Religion Council, I think it's called, it really lays the foundation for cities all over the world, really, having interfaith dialogue, interfaith meetings and events, and getting to know one another.
Thank you. Do you know that website offhand, or just?
The World's Council of Religion.
Okay.
Probably.org.
Okay, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anyone else like to share it?
We just always like to, as a secular, multicultural, multi-denominational organization, we always like to thank organizations like yours that support us. And being a part of it, of course, but the organizations in our community that support the 8,000 people a year that we get to serve, 4,000 families that we get to serve and touch in our community. Not just solving homelessness, but preventing it. Mm-hmm. Whenever we're on camera, we love to have an opportunity to say thank you. And on behalf of Betty McWilliams, our executive director, we thank all of you who support us.
Well, I like to say this also on camera, if people out there don't know, it is truly a blessing to have Foothill Unity Center in our city.
Yes.
Because, I indirectly, or actually directly, have used Foothill Unity Center. It was so funny that I had hurt my back, and Lois Gaston had come by, and she goes, Barbara, I had called her, she brought me some food. I said, no, I'm okay. And then she goes, well, I'm gonna bring some food to you. I go, okay. Then I get a phone call, And I'm listening to this voice. I'm you know, speaking. I go, why does that voice sound so familiar? And I literally had kind of just joined in with the Interfaith Council, but I knew their voice, and it was Betty. Mm-hmm. And because I couldn't get up, and I said, okay, I'm going to leave the door unlocked so they can just come in. Yeah. So I didn't know really where the food or anything was coming from.
Yes.
And because I just thought that what Foothill Unity Center did was feed the homeless.
Yeah.
Well, I wasn't, you know, but I was bedridden, you know. And so then, you know, then that's when I, oh, you do that also?
Yeah.
So, oh, my goodness. And then just recently, you know, I'm looking for a place. I go, oh, my goodness, this is just so crazy. Mm-hmm. And I serve on a committee with Tashira.
Mm-hmm.
And she goes, oh, no, Barbara. Let me. So she then contacts. And then within a week and a half, you know, I found a place.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, oh, my goodness, because I moved from down the street from you. I'm not there anymore. So I thought, oh, my goodness. So, you know, they just serve humanity.
Yeah. You know, we are, you know, as it relates to Interfaith Council, we are the hands and feet of your faith. In the Christian tradition, you know, when you were hungry, you gave me to eat. When you were thirsty, you gave me to drink. When you do this to the least of these, you do it unto me. A Foothill Unity Center serves the least of these that are either permanently or temporarily going through a tough time. And only 14% of those that we serve are actually homeless. It is, you know, whatever is left there, 83%, is that right? Percent of the people that we serve are housed, but just normal people that are working hard. But that's who you represent. You, the faith communities that you represent, are those normal people that are just trying to make it each day.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, the golden rules followed by all faith traditions.
Exactly.
So do unto others as you would want them to do unto you.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yes. So anyone else want to share? Okay. Well, thank you so much. This was truly exciting.
Thank you, Bob.
You know, I've been wanting to do this for a while.
Well, thanks for doing that.
But, you know, it's all about timing.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Yes.
It really is about timing. And it really wasn't about me, because I really wanted to do it when I wanted to do it at that time. But this all came together the way it's supposed to. When you step back and step and get you out of the way and let God do its work, you know, this beautiful thing happens.
That's great.
Yes.
Thanks.
So thank you all for coming. Thank you, thank you, thank you. This is not the last of us coming, so we'll be, you know, do some follow-up and just share different things that's going on.
Cool.
Okay?
All right, thank you.
Is that a promise? Okay.
Yay.
All right, thank you so much out there. Thank you for listening, and go out and be a blessing to someone. See you next time.